Yo, what's up guys, it's Gizola here and today I got you guys a brand new series where we're going to cover every little tips and tricks for zombies, and it's going to work for all the Call of Duty zombies, but this specific episode is going to be, of course, for Call of Duty World War II zombies, and it's gonna help out professionals like Carlos and noobs like Bob. You guys know Bob, he's crazy, but hey, also some of them are gonna be tips that you never heard, some of them will be a refresher for sure, and I got a ton of tips that will make it in this video. And in the upcoming ones as well. I started the series with Black Ops 3 and I had to cut it short, but it seems like I will be starting it back and doing it once in a while with Bob and Carlos because, hey, they are going to be over testimonial and everything like that. And hey, if you want to contribute to this, feel free to leave any tip in the comment section down below. Doesn't matter how big or small it is, I would love to feature your comment in the next episode if it's relevant. But hey, if you are new to the channel as well, make sure to subscribe and also let me know that too in the comments so I can just put you in my next video. But the first tip I got for you is basically going to be this: stopping and running once and twice, and basically this is gonna be a cycle. All right, this works in all of Call of Duty zombies, but this works like a charm in Call of Duty World War II zombies. Of course, you want to make sure you don't utilize this tip if you're playing Shangri-La or Origins. Let's say you're playing Shangri-La and hey, Bob is a across the whatever, it doesn't matter, right? He's across and there's a mud between. You're like, okay, let me just walk on that. Of course, you don't want to stop there, because if you stop there, that's gonna make you into a meme. Bob will be screaming, dank meme, so you don't want to do that. And of course, if you're playing Origins, you never want to do that. But hey, if you're playing Call of Duty World War II zombies, I'm gonna take like Grosten House for example. Now check this out, I will have relevant gameplay running in the background. So like Grosten House, such a small ass map, right? There are corners and there are more corners, but what I'm saying here is that when you're going around, you will find yourself in situations where you need to turn around and there will be zombies, and guess what, if you don't do this, you will end up going down, and you gotta use your intuition right here. So what you wanna do is, of course, there will be zombies behind you and there will be zombies in front of you. So what you want to do here is you want to stop and you want to run once again, and you want to stop and run once again, because what it does is that it makes zombies into this where they cannot hit you, right? And of course, that's exactly what we want. And when you stop and run once again, it's gonna give you that thrust where you will go bozo and Bob will be look at you and he will be screaming dank meme, and guess what, you will not go down, and while he's screaming dank meme, he will go down. That's what I'm saying. But at our number two spot, we have this tip, and this works really, really good in World War II zombies as well, and in any Call of Duty zombies. I'm making sure all of these tips are somewhat relevant to older Call of Duty games. And of course, in the coming months and years, we're gonna have Treyarch, we're gonna have Infinity Ward, we're gonna have Sledgehammer games once again. But what I'm saying here, I'm trying to make sure that this is relevant to all of the Call of Duty zombies, and of course, this is gonna be a specific one to World War II zombies. But number two, you wanna aim and shoot. Go for the head if zombies are behind you, if you know you can't go through. So basically what I'm saying here is that if you cannot do the stop and running thing, all you want to do is you want to aim and shoot the zombies. Of course, let's just say this, right? Let's make this let's create a scenario. So there are a couple of zombies, multiple zombies, and hey, guess what, Bob is down, and if you go down, basically the game is gonna end, and you don't want that. Let's just say that you don't want the game to end, because if the game ends, Bob will laugh at you, and of course you don't want that. Who want that, right? No, nobody. So zombies are behind you and your red screen, let's just throw that in as well, red screen, and there is a zombie in front of you, and let's say you're only on round 10 or 20, you can aim and shoot the zombie head, and guess what, he's gonna go down, and voila, you will have your path enabled, you will see everything, and you, of course, there will be Bob, and he will be like, damn son, you made it through, and you'll be looking at him and say like, well, that was easy, like I do that every single day. You will have that flexibility and you'll be able to say that in your normal games. Yes, in your normal game. But at our number three spot, now this tip, let me actually tell you what's up. Now you want to hip fire zombies in sticky situation, and guess what, this works like a charm in World War II zombies. Now check this out, in World War II zombies, they created this game in a way where if you shoot a zombie, they are going to react to bullets. Basically, if you shoot the zombie once, the zombie's gonna stop, meaning If you're red screen, he's not gonna hit you. That's what I'm saying. And I know Bob is already mind blown, but Bob, come back, Bob. We want you here. So you shoot the zombie, he will stop. And hey, if there are zombies all around you, you can just hip fire. And of course, if you have a LMG, then it's gonna be much better, because of course you're gonna have a lot more ammo, and it's gonna have more damage, right? So you can actually do that, and bada bim, bada boom, you know how that goes. But in Black Ops 3 or in past Call of Duty zombie games, it's not really gonna work. Of course, if you got Deadwire in Black Ops 3, then of course you wanna hip fire, and that can help you out and that sort of things. But in World War 2 zombies, it's just going to work, and it's gonna give you that time window where you can actually escape if you need to, right? And this has saved my life so many goddamn times, you have no idea. And of course Bob will have zero idea. Let's just say that, right? Bob is crazy, but hey, that's what I'm saying, ladies and gentlemen. But hey, at our number 4 spot, we're talking about this thing called buying ammo. And guess what, in Black Ops 3 it's not really gonna work, but in World War 2 zombie it works all the time. Let's say you have zero ammo, or let's just say you have 20 ammo in your mag, and you got 30 ammo in reserve. Of course, that's a very low amount of ammo, so you're in a situation where it's do or die. Basically, you can get ammo right now, or it's gonna be never, or you would have to do a whole circle, and that's gonna take you like 30 seconds or a minute. And hey, you know that you cannot wait that longer, because if you do, Bob's gonna be dead, because hey, Bob doesn't even have a gun. Bob's crazy, right? He doesn't even have shit. So you need to save Bob, and you need to save your life for the love of doesn't matter once again. But hey, guess what, you don't need to reload, you don't need to wait any longer. Just go around, hold square or X or F, doesn't matter once again, just buy ammo. And guess what, you don't even need to reload, and you will have maximum ammunition in your magazine and in your reserve. It just blew Bob's mind away when Carlos first told him. But hey, at our number 5 spot, I'm gonna hit you guys up with a banger, alright? Check this out once again. This one is going to be more of a noob's tip, but hey, I feel like it can really help you, because of course World War 2 Zombie is definitely new, and of course a lot of people are gonna be buying this game in a week's time, in 2 weeks time, and probably during or around Christmas time, right? So even if you're a professional, even if you are someone that has been playing zombies for a long ass time, this is something that you may not see it coming in your first game, or maybe even in your 10th game or whatever, right? But what I'm saying here is that you wanna use infinite ammo, and I'm gonna have two tips basically for this specific thing right here. So let's say you got free ammo. Now free ammo is a mod or consumable, I'm not sure what's that. I know, like, I'm making a how to get better at zombies video. And basically when you activate that, even if your gun has zero ammo, it's gonna give you an extra magazine. And on top, let's say if you have zero ammo in your magazine but you got plenty of ammo in reserve and you're about to reload, but guess what, you have infinite ammo that you know you need to use, you don't need to reload, you can activate your infinite ammo, and that's gonna reload your gun automatically. Of course you're not gonna see any animation happening for reloading per se, but you can actually start shooting and you can save your time that way. And of course if you need to use your infinite ammo, or if your infinite ammo meter is full, you definitely wanna use that. And that's basically two tips in a nutshell. And of course you can use other things like camouflage, but I personally don't like that much, because I often find myself in situations where infinite ammo, aka free fire, works best, but that's just me. But I'm gonna end this one with another banger. Now check this out, at our number 6 spot, this is gonna be such a, like, I'm not even sure what I wanna call this one. Of course we're gonna say it's a banger, but this one is just like a funny tip right here, because I've seen so many people down, you have like no idea, just because of this. Like basically what happens is that people will get hit 3 times, and of course if you got armor, that will kind of protect you and that sort of things. Of course armor is a great thing, you need to buy that, like right now Bob is already mind blown. But that's a basic tip, that's why I'm not including in this one, although I just did, but that's really not on my list. But of course you want to have armor, and let's just say you got hit 3 times, and now if you do get hit once again, of course the armor is gonna take care of you. But what if you don't have that armor? That's what I'm saying. So let's just say you don't have armor and you got hit so hard that even if you jump off a ledge, you're gonna go down and surprise a lot of people. I have seen a lot of people on stream. Even Bob, right? Bob got hit 3 times and guess what? He just jumped from the ledge and my man's dead. My man's dead. Because every time you jump off the ledge, you will receive a little pingy type of damage and that can kill you. Ladies and gentlemen, Call of Duty Zombies for you. Let me know if you have any tips so I can actually just take them and put your comment and feature your comment in the next episode. Of course, I will have some of my own and some of yours. I'm gonna mix that shit up and everything like that, and I want to have this sort of series for a longest time because of course we all love Bob and everything like that. But check out some other videos on the screen, subscribe if you're new, leave a like, and I'll see you very freaking soon.